And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the Houston Astros. First pitch coming your way next. Coming up on the first pitch and on the hill, Christian Javier.
Well, the big thing is that the way he holds his curveball, it's more of a knuckle curve. And because of that, it's less predictable in terms of the break for the hitter. That makes it that much harder to hit this guy.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz.
The first baseman, Yandy Diaz.
The wind and the pitch. Gonna count 1-2.
Not sure what's going on right there. No chance. Probably have some funny texts from his buddies after the game.
And now the count is even. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. Slider got him for strike three.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Here's Wander Franco. Out towards right center field. Tucker makes the grab, two down. Take a look at the lineup. At the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Luke Raley. Two down, nobody on. And a swing and a miss. And that's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
He goes down looking. The Rays strand just the one, and now the Astros go to work for the first time. No score. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on The Show. Back here in Houston, and starting this one, Shane McClanahan.
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way, because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
And stepping in for the Astros, Mauricio Dubon. Pitch misses outside. Ball two. And that's outside.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
Swing and a pop up. Franco sizes this one up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. Now we check out the Astros lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
Goes down swinging for the strikeout. He swung over top of the curveball.
Really good hard bite to that breaking ball for the strikeout right there. I mean, he was able to bury it down below the zone, and that's throwing the pitch with conviction. Good thing for the pitcher. He's not going to miss in the zone, and that's where you get hurt. Excellent execution with two strikes. That could be a big weapon for him in this start.
Swings and misses, struck him out. Astros are down quietly. We played an inning, no score. Back here in Houston, Isaac Paredes now. The pitch. And yeah, that's outside. And it's filled up.
Yeah, off to a good start. He's got to get the baseball, work quickly, and move the ball around. And that time, perfect pitch at the knees on the outside corner.
Eric Summersgill with home plate duty of this one. Kind of known for being generous with the corners, Chris.
You know, I think that used to be a lot bigger deal in past eras where pitchers were working more in and out with their pitches. But, yeah, we'll see if those corners come into play in this one. Hey, no pitcher's going to argue at all.
The second baseman, Brandon Love.
Lau at the plate. And now 2-1. Second inning here, no score. And now it's even up. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
And now it's Jose Siri. Swings and misses, and the inning is over. Nothing doing for Tampa. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here at Minute Maid Park, we head to the bottom of the second, and here's the first baseman, Jose Abreu. The 2-1. In the air, right field, pretty well struck back there to the warning track, makes the catch. Corey Jolks up next for the Astros. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Late swing, fouled off. One down, base is empty. That one missed. Pulls the string with the changeup, struck him out. Off to a strong start, Singy, as he's punched out three of the first five he's faced.
Well, he's definitely minimizing contact. He can get the swing and miss when he needs it, but he'll also keep the defense fresh behind him, allowing some balls in play as well.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ball popped up and it falls. And that extends the inning.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already is bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Step off, throw to first. And he's back standing. Pena leads off first with two down to the inning. Runner on the go. In the dirt. Over to Diaz. Third out. And now a man into scoring position. So one hit is all they get. We play two full. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. Top half of the third inning. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Christian Bethencourt.
Christian Bethencourt.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. A big blow to the home fans. The Rays strike first. It's 1-0.
Good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Josh Lowe next to hit for the Rays. And the right-hander deals.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Next offering upstairs. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. So now back to the top of the order.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Yandy Diaz now. And a swing and a miss.
Well, these Rays doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of him. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
1-2 now. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow jab of two strikes you're looking to protect, and halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
Now batting Wander Franco, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Javier throws over, and he's back safely.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
Just off the inside corner. Two balls, two strikes. And the pitch. Runner on the go. Pitch is low. Safe at second, and that was not close.
Well, with that kind of elite arm he has behind the plate, man, it's a pretty big deal when you can swipe a bag against this dude. Maybe more than anything, it prevents teams from just testing him, thinking that they can even steal the base. But right here, they successfully moved that runner up to scoring position. Good job.
Payoff pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, he took his chance at getting him to chase right there, but with first base open, walk not a bad thing. He set up a double play opportunity if he can induce a ground ball.
Swings and misses, and it's 1-2.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Here's a 1-2. In the dirt. Well done behind the dish. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Chased the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Well, it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Now it's Randy Arozarena. He's 0 for 1. The 2-1. And he grounds one to the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. Major League Baseball is on the show. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the inning. Here's the center fielder, Jake Myers. Kicks and fires. That's a little bit low. Swing and a miss.
Got some cut action to it. Velocity pretty good on that slider. So far, moving the ball around nicely.
And a swing and a miss. And one out now.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
The batter number 14.
Here's Mauricio Dubon.
Mauricio Dubon.
The 2-1. Good eye right there. And that clips the inside corner. And a pitch. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
This guy will throw any pitch at any count. 3-2. He goes off speed. Gets the out.
And now it's Alex Bregman. He was a strikeout victim his first time. 3-2 on the way. Swing and a miss, and that is that. So the Astros lead one. They still trail 1-0. Welcome back. On to the fourth. Down to third baseman, Isaac Paredes. And here it comes. Paredes tries to hold up, appeal to first, and yes, he offered at it. And now it's 1-2. Waves at the bender for the strikeout.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Swings and misses. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Now batter.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Jose Siri. Next offering upstairs.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
And there's a ball. And there's ball four.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Number 14.
Here's the catcher, Christian Bethencourt. He's already homered in this one. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Yeah, the batter now, Josh Lowe. Next pitch downstairs, 3-2 now. Three and two now. Bounce it back with two strikes. First and second, two down. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. No runs, a hit, two left. To the bottom of inning number four now. It's the Rays one, and the Astros nothing. And welcome back. Bottom four. And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Jose Abreu up to hit. Flied out his first time.
Jose Abreu.
The wind of the pitch.
Ball three.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count. Be ready to turn on a fastball.
That one finds the zone. Now 3-2. Home team down a run. The Rays leading on the solo homer. And he walked him.
The designated hitter, number nine.
One gone, runner at first. Stepping in, Corey Jolks. 0 for 1, he struck out swinging last time. And a pitch. Swing and a miss.
One ball,
and the count, 1-2. Inside, just missed.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Next pitch is popped up. Squeezes it, two away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
And next to hit for Houston, Jeremy Pena. Picked up a base hit to center his first time up. Abreu off of first with two away. And that one moves his feet. Next one off the plate inside. And a full count now. Chaz McCormick up next for the Astros. And a pitch. And that's ball four.
That's ball four.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice plate appearance.
So two down, Chaz McCormick up next for the Astros. 0 for 1 so far. Here comes a pitch. Good eye right there.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there, like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
Check swing, appeal to first. No swing, just held it back there. Got him swinging for the K. Pulled the string on the changeup. So they're able to work around a pair of walks in the inning. We played four. It's the Rays one and the Astros nothing. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Seth Martinez.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
So digging in, Yandy Diaz, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
And a payoff pitch. This one high in the air to left center. McCormick has it sized up. He's got it. And there's one down.
The batter, number five. Shortstop.
So up next, Wander Franco. Comes up empty. That's strike two. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Phil Maton up and throwing. Cunnell getting loose as well. Next offering upstairs.
It's a good take.
At the belt and fires. Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Now it's the DH, Luke Raley. A strikeout and a walk. Next offering is in for a strike. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Back up the middle and a base hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Runner at first with two away. Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. That one missing inside.
Good speed on the base paths. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
Now move to first, and he's back in safely. Right-handed reliever, and a foul ball. kick. Sandios. Swing and a miss, and he got him. That ends the frame. One left for Tampa, but they still lead it 1-0. Back here in Houston, we head to the bottom of the fifth. And now here's the speed threat. Outfielder Jake Myers. The 2-1. And that one almost got him.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
He just hasn't had great command of his pitches in this one. Definitely more walks than you'd like to see.
Martin Maldonado up to hit. He reached out a walk his first time.
Two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Here comes a 3-2. That one is absolutely belted way back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
Mauricio Dubon, the next to hit. Runner on the goal. On the ground, right side. Sneaks through, base hit. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot out there. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole. Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
And it's even up.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Two on, one out. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
The 2-2. Good eye in that spot.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Kyle Tucker waiting to hit for Houston. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Unafraid to throw it right there. That's trust in your stuff. Just one out away from getting out of a huge jam.
Here's Kyle Tucker. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. And a foul ball. Myers, the runner at third. Dubon at first. Two out of the inning. Off the plate inside. Now 2-2.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
2-1, two outs. And that one upstairs. Jose Abreu waiting for a turn at the plate. Looking for the K. So they strand a pair. Five innings complete. It's the Rays 1 and the Astros nothing. Back here at the ballpark. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. Here's the third baseman, Isaac Paredes. The count 2-1. Lined, and that's a base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's there with a leadoff double.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
And now it's Brandon Lau. That misses. Now two balls and a strike.
Well, these Rays really impressing me with the quality of their bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work.
They really made that opposing starter work in this one. Ran his pitch count up, and now they've got an opportunity to continue making things difficult on the bullpen.
That just misses, and that's ball three.
And no, they haven't broken through in a big way in the runs column, but with the way they're grinding out at bats, it definitely feels like there's potential for more coming.
Hard hit left side to first. Lau out on the play.
The bat, the center fielder, Jose Siri.
Jose Siri now at the plate. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. One out and a runner at second. Down the line towards the corner. Reaching for it, makes the catch. Runner tagging for third, and he moves up to third. Now two away.
The catch number 14.
And here's the catcher, Christian Bethencourt. His homer earlier is responsible for the only runs they've scored in this one.
Yeah, forget small ball. They're kind of living and dying by the long ball so far in this one.
The 1-1. Fouled off down the right side. Oh, that one rides up and in.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Two outs with a runner at third. Diving, and he can't make the play. In comes the run from third, and they lead by two. And his hot hitting continues.
They kept him in the yard that time, but all he's doing now is passing the baton, and everything seems to get started around this guy.
Two outs, runner on first. And stepping in for the Rays, Josh Lowe, the pitch. That's off the mark, 3-1 now. And ball four, two aboard.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Here's the Rays leadoff hitter, Yandy Diaz. Bethencourt, the lead runner at second. Lowe on at first with two down. Right through there, got him. Inning over, and it could have been worse. So one run in the inning on this base hit, and it's 2-0. Bottom of the sixth. And now the first baseman, Jose Abreu.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
That one misses. So a leadoff walk.
Pitch count's getting up there now. And not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
And the Rays manager making his way towards the mound now as he will make the move. Shane McClanahan departs, and he was a tough nut to crack. Pretty stingy from start to finish. Back with a new arm after a Kevin Kelly gets handed the rock out of the pen.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And the righty deals. Oh, and the zone doesn't get the call. Two balls and a strike. Fly ball down the line. Lowe has it sized up. Makes the grab. And there's one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit. And then from there can really settle in.
So next up for Houston, Jeremy Pena. And a 1-1. And another ball. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Sean Armstrong preparing to come on if needed. The pitch. Swings through that one out in front that time. Righty delivers. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And he deals. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Now two out. Chaz McCormick up next for the Astros. The 1-1. That's to third. They get the force. Play made. That ends the inning. One left for Houston, and they're down 2-0. So a new pitcher out of the bullpen for the Astros, Phil Maton. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Phil Maton.
And now Wander Franco.
Well, both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
So now 1-2.
1-2.
Righty to the plate. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Right-hander kicks, deals. Outside. That one ran inside, almost got him.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Kicks and fires. And there's ball four.
Perfect.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
And now the DH, Luke Raley, 1-2. Franco on at first, nobody out. And a base hit into right. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Everything came together for him. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. 1-1 now. Started to swing, held up.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
2-1 now, two aboard. That's down and in. Action in the pen down there. Joel Cunnell, the young right-hander, up and throwing. No outs, runners at first and second. Hit in the air, right field. Tucker should have it. He's there. He's got it. Runner tags up for third. And the throw's offline, safe at third.
Now back, the third baseman. Paredes.
Now the third baseman, Isaac Paredes. One for three.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Here's a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Pitch. Got him swinging.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau. The 1-1 is fouled off. Corners are occupied with two down. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Couple of strikeouts with runners on. Sometimes you got to really bear down, and he did just that. Nice job of getting out of the jam and out of the inning.
Set for the last half of the seventh. And now the center fielder, Jake Myers. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, these Astros showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They've already earned 5 walks in the game, and of course, that's providing them with a lot of run scoring opportunities. Committed to that breaking ball just a little too much and couldn't pull the bat back in time. Once you get it going, it can be so tough to stop the momentum of that barrel. Good pitch, had him fooled.
Next one is off the play. 2-1. Next offering clips the zone count even at 2.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least 1 run. Then maybe you get 2 or 3.
Next offering is fouled back. Down looking.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with 2 strikes.
And stepping in for the Astros, Mauricio Dubon. The 1-1 is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs.
Really good take, especially with 2 strikes.
That misses. Ball 3. Alex Bregman up next for the Astros. The kick, the 3-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Payoff pitch on the ground to the left. Franco on to first, and that is the inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They trail it here 2-0. New pitcher now, Ryan Stanek. This guy can bring it velocity-wise. And stepping in for the Rays, Jose Siri. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
The 1-1. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. Slider clips the corner.
Two balls, two strikes.
Two-two. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two-two now. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Falling behind 2-1. Bullpen activity starting up now. Joel Cunnell appears to be getting loose. And the right-hander deals. Now this is in the air down the line. This looks like extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And he's got a double, fourth hit of the night for him.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
One out, runner at second. Josh Lowe next to hit for the Rays. Left-hand batter waits. That one missed. The pitch. Fought off foul.
Look out. That ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines. Just ensures safety for the fans. Last thing as a player, you want to look up and see a fan get hit.
Now that's smacked to right center. And no one can get there. It falls in. Throws to second. And he's in there. And a run comes in to score.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Great hands on that swing. Took the barrel right to the baseball, caught it out front, and ripped it into the gap. At that point, there's probably no question in his mind that he was going for two. That's just a great feeling.
So the lineup flips over. Yandy Diaz next to hit for the Rays. That smash towards center. Makes the grab on the run. And there's two away.
It was all over that fastball right there. I tell you what, if he gets under it just by a fraction of an inch or a little bit more, that's way back.
Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. And it goes just foul. Next pitch is outside. Man on second, two down. Two outs and one in scoring position. Check swing at the full count offering. Appeal to third. Did not go.
Well, a good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number three, and the free bags keep on coming. You down with OBP, Boone?
So two down now, and here is Luke Raley. The 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's now 3-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Righty reliever out of the pen, Jason Adam.
Number 47, Jason Adam.
Here's Alex Bregman.
Leading up for the Astros.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
He goes down looking.
Well, this is no secret. That slider is going to be his go-to pitch. Everyone in the ballpark knows it. It's a massive part of his arsenal, and he'll throw it a lot and in pretty much any count, any situation, and he's going to look to punch guys out as well. I tell you what, the effectiveness of that slider is always a big key for him.
Kyle Tucker digs in now. And now one and two. Here's a 1-2. Now a check swing, but he held up. Let's go, Astros. Misses, 3-2. And now it's 3-2. And he walked him.
Ball four.
Close pitch there, but you got to forget about that call if you're out on the mound. You can't let it affect you going forward. You've got to get out of the inning first. And then if you want to be frustrated, take it out in the dugout.
Tucker leads off first with one away. Line drive, base hit right field. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
First and second, one out. Next to hit, Corey Jolks. That's in there. That's strike two.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. Siri in position. Drops into the glove. Two down. So first and second with two outs. Jeremy Pena up next for the Astros. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. This one in the dirt. Nothing happening on the bases, though. And the pitch. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Here's Tucker on his way to the plate. The throw is offline, and he's in to score. And now just a two-run deficit. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
So they turn to the lefty in this spot, Colin Poche.
And he's got a big-time breaking ball to contend with. Hitters going to have to pick it up early if they're going to have any chance. Colin Poche.
Substitution now at second base. Pinch running here. Greg Kessinger. Chaz McCormick getting ready to hit. Next one misses, 2-2. Activity in the bullpen. Pete Fairbanks warming up for manager Kevin Cash. And Poche ready to work. Swing and a ball lifted left field. And that is a foul ball. And now the count filled up 3-2. So both runners should be on the move here on the full count pitch.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie up this ball game. See if you can find some open grass in the outfield.
And now the lefty. Swung on, belted. That one back. And it's gone. Home run. Chaz McCormick muscles one out, and they take the lead. It's 4-3.
Impressive swing of the bat to go over the wall to the opposite field gap. And you know, there are a lot of guys that just don't have the pop to do that, and probably just as many who don't have the approach either. He let that ball travel, and he got great extension on the follow through to drive it out of here.
So two down, and next to hit for Houston, Jake Myers.
Nothing but curveballs so far in the at-bat. Kind of makes it difficult as a hitter to know what to look for, because you start wondering if he'll keep coming with it or if they'll try to speed you up.
Two outs. Fouls it off, still 1-2. The pitch. Myers started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first, didn't go. And down on strikes, and that ends the inning. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. Last chance for the Rays coming up. Now into the game, Greg Kessinger. He takes over as the new first baseman. So here comes Ryan Pressly to the mound.
Save opportunity for him right here, and he's their guy. Time to lock this one down and get out of here with the W.
Well, one run game. Now at the plate, Randy Arozarena. Pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike.
When you get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if you will.
That one misses. Yeah, the closer in danger of walking the tying run. Isaac Paredes to bat next. out there to center. And there's one down. That's a big first out right there, and that changes things.
Yeah, you can kind of see how just the hope and optimism has shrunk a little bit, but they got a couple more outs to work with. They got to find a way to get a runner on and get one around the bases.
Ball to strike. Dribbled up the third baseline, and he grabs it in foul ground. And a pitch. Not even close there. It's 2-2. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Gets a piece and stays alive. And a pitch. Fights it off. He'll see another. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit.
Love how he became a really tough out with two strikes right there. He couldn't get any air under it, but he smoked that ball back up the middle. Timing was just perfect. Got great wood on it, and there's just no chance for the infielders with how hard he hit it.
Brandon Lau, next to hit for the Rays. Off the mark there, and it's 2-1 with a single base runner. Because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. At the belt and fires. High drive, deep right field, way back there, out of here. That was a moonshot, and now they're out in front. It's 5-4.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
New arm out of the bullpen, Joel Cunnell.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
One down. Here's the center fielder, Jose Siri. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. On the ground, right side, and it gets by him.
That's now three hits in a row for the offense. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
So, man aboard. Now, Christian Bethencourt. He's already homered in this game. Close, but called a ball. 2-1. Right-handed reliever. That's a little bit low. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
So one out with two aboard. Now it's the right fielder, Josh Lowe. Three, two now. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. 3-2. And that'll load the bases.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
So digging in, Yandy Diaz. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Swings and misses, and that's strike two.
He's had a tough day at the plate, three strikeouts already. It's hard not to think negative, but you got to find a way to somehow center up the baseball and put it in play.
Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Up next to Tampa Bay.
Stepping in is the switch hitting shortstop, Wander Franco.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Lined, and that's a base hit. One runs in. A second scores as well, and they're up by three.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bolt the other way.
Astros go to the pen, and here comes Rafael Montero.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
First and second, two outs. Next is the designated hitter, Luke Raley. Ripped to third, but handled, and that'll end the inning. So an incredible rally here at the top of the ninth has completely flipped the script of this game. And 9-1-2 scheduled to lead off the bottom of the ninth. It's the Rays 7 and the Astros 4. Pete Fairbanks takes over on the mound.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
At the plate is the Astros catcher, Martin Maldonado.
The catcher, Martin Maldonado.
Here's a 1-1. To third, has some trouble with it. Not in time. He's safe.
These guys today are so great at handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
So the Houston lineup turns over. Digging in, Mauricio Dubon. The 1-2 goes down looking for the strikeout. He's got to be frustrated with that call. Now it's Alex Bregman.
Number two, Alex Bregman.
Here comes a pitch. Strike two. And that's too high. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, all game these guys had to battle with that 10th man, those fans making a lot of noise, but they took the lead in the ninth inning, quieted things down. We were able to get those final three outs in the bottom half as well. Just a very well executed ball game.
This one finishes with a final of 7-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Rays, 7 runs on 13 hits, no errors.